Let's talk about the Bagong Pilipinas hymn and pledge. From the point of view of a political analyst, a seasoned political analyst, how necessary is it, or how necessary is this move to require national government agencies, including state universities and colleges, as well as government-owned and controlled corporations, to actually sing or play and recite the hymn and the pledge during flag ceremonies?
My understanding of Bagong Pilipinas is the government is trying to define their governance mindset, one that is accountable, principled. And with that in mind, I believe it's within the rights of our government to define it for those who work under them. But key to understanding government is they need to be accountable. They need to be principled. So I don't find anything wrong with it. But we need, again, as government speaks of accountability, as government speaks of principles, then we might need to make them accountable on what Bagong Pilipinas is all about. If this is the mindset that our government wants us to inculcate for our youth in state universities, for our government workers, then we make the highest level to the lowest level of government service to our scholars in state universities that opportunity to project that they are accountable to the Filipino people and to the Filipino nation, not only through hymns, not only through actions or programs, but actual reality that this is the principle of the Filipino nation moving forward under the Marcos Jr. administration.
And finally, Dindo, would it be fair to say that President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. with this memorandum order is actually borrowing a page from the playbook of his father?
Not necessarily. On the case of former president, father, he was emphasizing this during a dictatorial, authoritarian PNUDOM's presidency. In the case of President Marcos, he is an elected, legitimate leader until 2028. So his actions simply reflect what the people gave him as a mandate. So for me, as long as we are in this democratic space, government should be allowed to push the mindset, what in the words, principled and accountable thinking, the governance of the BBM administration. I don't see negative with that. We just have to be more vigilant that we protect our own democratic society to ensure that this type of accountability does not translate into non-democratic means.
Vigilance and accountability, keywords of the day. Thank you so much for joining us this morning, Dindo Manhit of Strat-Based ADR Institute.
Thank you.